Good morning, Vandana. Till now, we have studied briefly about discrete time Fourier transform and Z transforms. Today, we are going to discuss about discrete Fourier series. Consider a sequence x tilde of n that is periodic with period n, so that x tilde of n equals to x tilde of n plus rn for any integer r. That means we construct some periodic sequence x tilde of n with period of capital N. Similar to continuous time periodic signals, these kind of periodic sequences can be represented by a Fourier series corresponding to some of harmonically related complex exponential sequences. We already studied Fourier series for continuous time case, right? We didn't represent a periodic signal as a linear combination of harmonic components. In the same manner, we can try to represent any periodic sequence as a linear combination of harmonically related complex exponential sequences. Very complex exponentials with frequencies that are integer multiples of fundamental frequency 2 pi by n. If capital N is the period of this particular sequence, 2 pi by n is the fundamental frequency of this one, and the harmonics for them are 2 pi by n into k. 2 pi by n into k corresponds to kth harmonic. It's a fundamental frequency, right? These periodic complex exponentials are of the form e power j 2 pi by n into kn. This is a kth harmonic, right? You can see this one. This corresponds to omega k. This is omega k, which is equal to 2 pi by n into k, kth harmonic. And you can see this is periodic with period of capital N. If you can cross check this one, simply do ek of n plus rn, replacing n with n plus rn. And then in the second term, as n gets cancelled out, we are going to get e power j 2 pi rk, where r and k are integers. It means rk also integer. That means we are getting e power j 2 pi into some integer, which is equals to 1. The second part will become like 1. And that will be same as this, right? Ek of n. Then the Fourier series representation has a form x tilde of n equals to 1 by n sigma k x tilde of k e power j 2 pi by n into kn. See, we already know that the period of this one is capital N. Period of each and every harmonic in this one is capital N, right? Each one is periodic with the period of n. That's for sure. And the signal we can show on the left side also periodic with the period of capital N. Now that period got matched, right? This period is same as this period. Both are having the same period, capital N. Fourier series representation of a continuous time periodic signal generally requires infinitely many harmonically related complex exponentials. For example, if you construct square wave, we are going to represent that as a linear combination of odd harmonics, right? That we have seen in the continuous time scenario. Till infinite harmonic. That is why we have infinite harmonics. Whereas Fourier series for any discrete time signal with period n requires only n harmonically related complex exponentials. You don't require infinite harmonics. You just required capital N number of harmonics. Let's see how. As you already know that e naught of n equals to en of n, e1 of n equals to en plus 1 of n. This we already saw in the starting classes, right? While finding the periodicity of the complex exponentials. See, the meaning of this one is that DC component is same as nth harmonic, right? Both are same. In this case, first harmonic is same as n plus 1 harmonic. Let's try to cross check this. Ek plus rn of n, where r is any integer. That means we are trying to look into k plus rnth harmonic. K plus Rn harmonic. We want to look into this one. e power j 2 pi by n into k plus rn into n. If you consider the second term, this n gets cancelled out, we are going to get e power j 2 pi rn. Then this part is simply equals to 1, right? Because rn is some integer, e power j 2 pi into integer is equals to 1. Then you are going to end up with this one, e power 1 j 2 pi by n into kn, which is same as e k fn. Now you can see, there is no difference between k plus rnth harmonic and kth harmonic, right? Consequently, the set of n periodic complex exponential e naught of n, e 1 of n up to n minus 1 of n defines all existing periodic complex exponentials with frequencies that are integer multiples of 2 pi by n. That means we have only n possible unique periodic signals with a period of n, right? Unique complex exponentials, n possible unique complex exponentials which are having a period of n. These are the only unique things. That the Fourier series representation of a periodic sequence X tilde of n needs to contain only n of these complex exponentials, because they are just repetition, right? If you go for higher harmonics, that looks something similar to the harmonics between 0 to n minus 1, right? For notational convenience, we choose k from 0 to n minus 1. See, if you want, you can consider any continuous n interval. If you want, you can consider from k equals to 1 to n, or k equals to 2 to n plus 1, like that. You can consider any continuous capital N harmonics. So, x tilde of n equals to 1 by n sigma k equal to 0 to n minus 1 x tilde of k into e power j 2 pi k by n into n. This is a kth harmonic, right? So, kth harmonic. We are having total till n minus 1 harmonic. K equal to 0 to n minus 1 is varying. This is a frequency, right? Digital frequency. 2 pi k by n, where k runs from 0 to n minus 1. To obtain the sequence of Fourier series coefficients x tilde of k from the periodic sequence x tilde of n, we exploit the orthogonality of set of complex exponential sequences. Let's see how you can do this. X tilde of n equals to 1 by n sigma k equals 0 to n minus 1 x tilde of k e power j 2 pi k by n into n. Multiply both sides with complex conjugate of this one, right? E power minus j 2 pi by n into rn, and summing from n equal to 0 to n minus 1. If you do this one, we are going to get this, and we can interchange these two summations. There is no problem, right? Once you interchange these two summations, we are going to end up with this one. You can take this inside this one, because this is constant with respect to n, right? X tilde of k. There is no problem at all in this. And the constant simplification is as follows. You can see this one. This summation equals to 1 for k minus r equals to mn, where m is some integer. And that's equal to 0 otherwise. You can try to see what happens when k minus r equals to mn. If k minus r equals to mn, this capital N gets cancelled out. You are going to get e power j 2 pi into mn. E power j 2 pi into mn is same as equals to 1 for integer m and n, right? So you are going to get sum of this n times. You are adding 1 n times. You are going to get n. N by n is 1. That's why you are getting 1. When k minus r is not equals to mn, and if you try to simplify this one, this is a geometric series, right? Then you are going to end up with 0. You can cross check that. It implies that sigma n equals 0 to n minus 1, x tilde of n, e power minus j 2 pi by n into rn equals to x tilde of r. So the Fourier series coefficients extilia of k are obtained from extilia of n using the following relation. Extilia of k equals to sigma n equal to 0 to n minus 1 extilia of n into e power minus j 2 pi by n into kn. We can observe that this particular sequence also periodic with a period of n. We can cross check this, right? You can simply substitute k plus capital N in place of k both sides, then you are going to end up with the same expression. It means extilia of n equals to extilia of 0, extilia of n plus 1 equals to extilia of 1, and so on. More generally, we can say that extilia of k plus Rn is same as extilia of k for any integer k. Let us denote Wn equals to e power minus j 2 pi by n. Then we can call it like analysis equation. Extilia of k equals to sigma n equals 0 to n minus 1. Extilia of n, Wn power k. And the synthesis equation is as follows. Extilia of n equals to 1 by n, sigma k equals 0 to n minus 1. Extilia of k, Wn power minus k. You can see both of them are periodic with a period of capital N. The advantage to interpreting Fourier series coefficients as a periodic sequence is that we can find duality between time domain and frequency domain, because both looks like periodic signals with period of capital N only, right? We can try to have some duality relation between them. The duality is as follows. Extilia of n implies extilia of k is a discrete Fourier series for this one. And suppose in the time domain, the sequence is capital extilia of n. This is a sequence. In the frequency domain, we are going to get the particular sequence like capital N into small extilia of minus k. This is a duality relation. For example, consider periodic impulse train. You can see this extilia of n equals to sigma r delta of n minus rn. It means that this particular impulse is repeating at every n interval, capital N interval. The period of this one is capital N, right? And these are the DFS coefficients. Extilia of k equals to sigma n equals 0 to n minus 1. It should be extilia of n into Wn power kn. We know that within 0 to n minus 1 interval, extilia of n is same as delta of n. Remaining all of them are zeros, right? From 0 to n minus 1 interval. That's why I am substituting this one into this. If you substitute this one, that is same as this. At n equal to 0, we are getting this one equals to 1. 1 into Wn power k into 0, which is same as Wn power 0, which is equals to 1. Extilia of k equals to 1. In this case, extilia of k equals to 1 for all k. And we are trying to represent that mathematically using this synthesis equation. This is a synthesis equation, right? We know the synthesis equation is extilia of n equals to 1 by n sigma k equal to 0 to n minus 1 extilia of k into e power j 2 pi k n by n, right? It's a synthesis equation. And we are replacing extilia of k equals to 1 here. You can say this one. It's a synthesis equation, which is same as this actual expression, right? This actual expression for extilia of n. You can see this actual expression. That means this particular periodic sequence can be represented mathematically in this form also. The two are identical. This one and this one. The two are equal. This direct equation is a synthesis equation. You are trying to synthesize this extilia of n with the help of complex exponential sequences. periodic complex exponential sequences. Consider periodic rectangle pulse train. This is a rectangle pulse, right? The periodic rectangular pulse. Here n equals to 10. The period of this one is 10. For every 10, this is repeating, right? You can see this 0 to n minus 1. N minus 1 means 9. Up to this, this is one period. And after that, 10 to is going up to 19, right? Skips on repeating. Next 20 to 29 and so on. So simply repeat. This particular pattern will repeat. It's a periodic sequence. Now again find DFS coefficients as follows. X tilde of k equals to sigma n equals 0 to n minus 1. Here n equals 10, right? That's why this is n. X tilde of n, w n power k n. N equals to 10, capital N. And if we simplify this one, you can see this. This is equals to 1 in the interval 0 to 4 and equal to 0 otherwise, right? If you consider 0 to 9 interval. Then if you simplify this one, we are going to end up with this. Still have k equals to e power minus j 2 pi, e power minus j 4 pi k by 10 into sin pi k by 2 by sin pi k by 10. And if you try to plot the magnitude response of this one, mod of this one, if you try to find mod of this, this magnitude is always 1. And this will be mod sine pi k by 2 by mod sine pi k by 10. This will be the pattern. And this is a constant phase. Let's look into periodic convolution. We have already seen linear convolution of aperiodic signals, right? For an aperiodic signals, if you want to find the convolution x1 of n, convolution with x2 of n, that will be simply sigma k equals to minus infinity plus infinity x1 of k into x2 of n minus k. That is for aperiodic signals, right? But for the periodic signals, we will try to consider over one period. The summation is over one period. You can see this one. M equal to 0 to n minus 1. This corresponds to one period, right? A capital N is the period. Sigma m equal to 0 to n minus 1. X1 tilde of m. X2 tilde of n minus m. If this is aperiodic, then this will go from minus infinity to plus infinity. As this is periodic, we will try to consider only from 0 to n minus 1. And we are calling it like periodic convolution. It's a periodic convolution. The constant DFS for this one, discrete Fourier series for this periodic convolution is same as multiplication in the frequency domain. X1 tilde of k into X2 tilde of k. Periodic convolution leads to multiplication for the DFS coefficients. For example, consider some periodic signal or periodic sequence as follows, X2 tilde of m. It's a periodic with a period of n, right? You can see this one, 0 to n minus 1 is one period. And once again, n to n plus n minus 1. It means 2n minus 1. N to 2n minus 1 is one more period. It keeps on repeating, right, this pattern. And similarly, x1 tilde of m is also periodic with a period of n. In this case, both of them are having the same period. X1 tilde of m is having a period of capital N. X2 tilde of m also having a period of capital N. Both are having the same period. And you are trying to apply periodic convolution for these two signals which are having the same period. And according to this expression, we need to fold this. See, this one can be written like this, right? X2 tilde of n minus m equals to x2 tilde of minus of m minus n. It means that we can fold x2 tilde of m first, then we are going to get x2 tilde of minus m. After that, shift that particular folded signal right side by n samples. then we are going to get x2 tilde of minus of m minus n, which is same as x2 tilde of n minus m. Folding first, after that shifting right side by n samples. This is x2 tilde of minus m. You can say this, this is x2 tilde of m. X2 tilde of minus m means we need to fold with respect to this zero, right? With respect to this axis at zero, you need to fold this entire thing. Once you fold this one, what happens is, you see minus 1, right? Minus 1 become like plus 1 and minus 2 becomes like plus 2, minus 3 becomes like plus 3 and so on. Minus of n minus 1 becomes like n minus 1 once you fold this one. You can see that, right? You see, after folding, you have folded this one. Now, I want to shift this by one sample. You can see. If I want to find the first sample in this one, that means I want to see what is this for small n equals to 1. In that case, I need to do this one, right? X2 tilde of 1 minus m. Let's consider that x2 tilde of 1 minus m, which is same as x2 tilde of minus of m minus 1. After folding, you are shifting this folded sequence right side by one sample. You can shift this right side by one sample, right? That means this 0 will be shifted to 1, 1 will be shifted to 2, minus 1 here, this minus 1 will be shifted to 0, right? You can say this. Shifting right side by one sample. And x2 tilde of 2 minus m corresponds to shifting the sequence right side by 2 units or 2 samples. You can see this, right? One more sample shift for this. And for computing this periodic convolution, we need to bother about only the interval from 0 to n minus 1. No need to worry about remaining interval, right? This interval is enough for computing that one. For n equals to 1, you will multiply x1 tilde of m with this particular sequence. And after that, you'll try to add everything, right? It's like dot plot between x1 tilde of m and x1 tilde of 1 minus m in this interval. Similarly, to compute the value of that cyclic convolution at n equals to 2, you'll try to take the dot plot of x1 tilde of m with this particular sequence, x2 tilde of 2 minus m. And you need to compute till capital N minus 1. You need to compute the cyclic convolution values or this periodic convolution values from small n equal to 0 to capital N minus 1. Because the periodic convolution of these two particular sequences, these two sequences, leads to once again periodic sequence with a period of capital N. That's also having the period of capital N. That means you need to compute the remaining things. If you are able to compute from small n equal to 0 to n minus 1, then that's more than enough, right? You can duplicate that one. Let's have a look into relationship between Fourier series coefficients, that means DFS coefficients, and Fourier transform of one period. For example, consider this periodic signal with a period of 10. You can see this 0 to n minus 1, it means 0 to 9. See one period, and this pattern will repeat. Over one period means x of n equals to 1 from 0 to 4 and equal to 0 for 5 to 9, right? This is covering over one period, capital N equals to 10. Now, if you try to apply Fourier transform for this particular a periodic sequence, this is DTFT, right? Sigma n equal to 0 to 4, this is 1 into e power minus j omega n, and remaining interval that is 0, right? Then we are going to end up with this expression e power minus j to omega into sine 5 omega by 2 by sine omega by 2. And we already saw that x tilde of k equals to e power minus j pi k by 10 into sin pi k by 2 divided by sin pi k by 10, right? This we already saw in the previous examples. Are you finding any similarity between this and this? Can I just say this, right? It's a DDFT, it's a DFS. DTFT over one period, and this is a discrete Fourier series. If I simply sample this omega at every 2 pi k by 10, that means at every interval of 2 pi by 10, if you try to sample that one, then you are going to get DFS coefficients. Just replace omega equals to 2 pi k by 10 into this expression. Then you are going to end up with this expression. That means you are trying to sample this DTFT at every 2 pi by 10 interval, right? Where k is integer. You are trying to change k from 0 to n minus 1. That means you are going to have capital N number of samples, 0 to n minus 1, right? That many samples you are constructing for x of e power j omega in order to get these DFS coefficients. It's a general result where this denominator corresponds to period, right? Capital N. This is DTFT for that particular signal over one period. And this is a concerned thing. DFS coefficients magnitude. These are simply samples. You can see this one, right? These are simply samples. It's one sample, another one, third sample, fourth sample, fifth one, sixth sample, seventh one, eighth one, ninth one, tenth one, like this, right? You have 10 samples from this point to this point. You have 10 samples, right? After that, there is just a repetition. You can see this one. This height is same as this height, right? You can see these samples are repeating once again, and they are repeating once again like this, right? It's a periodic pattern. That means using DFS, we are trying to sample this particular DTFT at regular intervals. The each and every interval is 2 pi by 10 in this case, or 2 pi by capital N, right? Say 0, 2 pi by 10, and this corresponds to 2 pi into 2 by 10, 2 pi into 3 by 10, 2 pi into 4 by 10, 2 pi into 5 by 10, and so on. This is 2 pi into 9 by 10, and this one corresponds to 2 pi into 10 by 10. 2 pi into 10 by 10 is same as 2 pi, right? Say 2 pi. This is one more interpretation of that one. We just construct Z plane. Z is a complex plane, right? Real part and imaginary part. And over the unit circle, you can find the DTFT, right? When mod Z equals to 1. And if DTFT exists, we can simply substitute Z equal to e power j omega to get the DTFT, right? You can substitute simply Z equal to e power j omega in X of Z. To get x of e power j omega. This corresponds to DTFT. And we are trying to sample that at every 2 pi by n interval, right? To get DFS coefficients. You can see this one. At 0, you are sampling 2 pi by n. And 2 pi by n into 2, 2 pi by n into 3, 2 pi by n into 4, and so on, right? This is a case where capital N equals to 8. That means we are trying to take 8 samples over this circle, right? This is k equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. K equals to 7. We are trying to consider N samples over this. थैंक यू।